Yo guys, welcome to RenderRam, my name is Vieku, and today we're gonna be covering this trendy material that I've seen everywhere, and it's called Sherpa. There's also this similar thing which is called Boucle. So what is Sherpa? Well, it's this thing. I recently went some furniture shopping, and literally half of the furniture is this material, so I realized it's trendy, so I want it to be trendy also, and I now have this hat. So the first thing that you can notice about this material is that it's super fluffy, and you practically look like you are a sheep, or you are sitting on a sheep when you sit on a sofa like that. But for our choice of sofa, I have this beauty here, and this beauty here is made by Evermotion, and it's Arc Models Volume 257. Highly recommend you check this out. They have really, really cool sofas here, and all of them are amazing quality. So yeah, Evermotion website, I'm gonna leave the link in the description. Check this out. For our texture for the Sherpa, I'm gonna be using this. So I found this site called swatchsupply.com, and here you can actually buy a Sherpa pattern, which gives really nice results in my opinion. So yeah, I'm gonna also leave the link for this down below. First thing that you can notice about this fabric is that it has this texture, you know, this sheep-like texture. And so yeah, we're gonna probably use some sort of a displacement for it. What I'm gonna do, I'm just gonna select my whole sofa, go to our modifier list, I'm gonna use displacement. This approach can be done in any rendering engine, in any 3D software, so I think the same logic can be applied everywhere. So how does it look? So I've just applied my displacement, and what I'm gonna do, I have my material here. This is that Sherpa texture that I mentioned earlier. So I'm just gonna drop it in as an instance. And as you can see, I made my power to be 1.5 centimeter. I played with the center a little bit. Center is like how much does the texture, you know, in displacement go up or down. Our effect now looks like this. Okay, so first thing that you can notice is that the whole thing is pretty much very dark, you know, and why is it dark? It's actually very logical, because we added a lot of these definitions, and all of them cost tons of shadows, and it just makes the whole thing dark. Does it look fluffy? Does it look soft? Absolutely not. Does it look like my trendy hat? No. How are we gonna approach it? By the way, there are some cracks in the displacement, and there's gonna be a new version of F-Storm which will have all these displacement issues fixed, but it's not that critical for this example. So yeah, our general Sherpa currently looks like it's made out of rough cardboard, and no, it doesn't look soft. So the way I generally approach Sherpas is, as you can see, it has like some sort of base, and then you have the fluffiness on top of it. Because when I was doing this, my first approach was to generally crank translucency, so I would just copy this, paste it here, and I would get this effect. Not only it took ages to render, but in general, the whole thing looked like a hollow balloon, and no, you know, just dropping translucency onto everything just doesn't do the job. So I actually dissected the actual material and tried to replicate it in 3D, and I was happy. So, as you can see, we have our base material here, and on top of it, we have the sharpiness. So what I'm gonna do now is, I'm gonna delete this displacement, I'm gonna clone the whole thing. So I'm gonna clone it, I'm just gonna go to that material where I've set my translucency, I'm gonna kill it, set it to 0 so it's not translucent. Now, with me cloning this material, so what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna add a tiny push to it. What I'm trying to generally do, I'm trying to keep my base to be a base, and I'm trying to add a second object which is actually gonna act like this fluffy thingy. So for the push, I'm just gonna set that push to be, let's say, 1 millimeter, so nothing crazy. Next, I'm gonna add my F-Storm displacement here, and yeah, let's keep it like this, 1.5, 0.6, and that is okay. Now here's where the magic comes. We have our base material, which is this. And then I have my Sherpa material. As you can see, I'm not using directly any textures here. So it's just a raw material. And this will be my Sherpa material. And as you can see, I have that translucency to 1 here, and I have my color here. So if I apply this material directly to that clone that has F-Storm displacement, right, maybe not this, because I forgot to link my displacement texture, but this. And now would you look at that? It really does look kind of fluffy. Just keep in mind, this method, since you're using double objects and one has translucency, etc., it's not exactly render time friendly, It will slow down things a little bit, but I kind of believe it's worth it, because look at this now. If I zoom in, we got this nice fluffiness happening everywhere, and yeah, now it kind of resembles, you know, this whole kind of feeling. And now when we just compare it, I'm just gonna kill my translucency, and you can see the hardness in the shadows that are happening, and it's not really, it doesn't look very, very good. But here's the thing, we limited how much translucent it is. So because of that, we created those two objects. One is serving as a base layer and the other one is serving as that fluffiness. And the base layer is actually preventing the translucent fluffiness to kind of pierce all the way through it, which makes our sofa generally look like a balloon or something like that. So yeah, this is my approach and how I do Sherpa materials. And yeah, when we zoom out and just look at the whole thing, it just looks gentle, it looks fluffy, and all the elements are there. So yeah, I think I'm pretty satisfied with how this looks. And yeah, you can maybe try this method and see how it works for you. And that's it for today, guys. I hope you learned something new. I hope your Sherpas are gonna look much better, or your Boucles, or whatever trendy things are modern today. And yeah, don't forget to check out Evermotion's website, where you can find out all the cool news in our CGI world. You can create nice mud shaders in V-Ray. You can do a bunch of other stuff. Look, even fluffy cars are modern now. This one looks awesome. Okay, see you in the next video. Bye.